Hello again, Interwebs. Welcome back. My name's Tethys, and today we're continuing our playthrough of Stardew Valley. Last episode, we ended up getting an upgrade for our pickaxe, as well as finishing the first bundle in the community center. And we've also started planting the three crops that we need for the next community center in the pantry for spring crops. And we also ended up getting quite a bit of money from all the crops that we sold yesterday, the day before on it. Recipe request for you. I need fresh cauliflower for a recipe I want to make. Could you bring me one? I can, because we actually have one more growing, I think. Yes, we do. So once that finishes, we'll be able to turn that in and get some cash, which will be nice. In the meantime, while we wait for those crops to grow, we are going to water them and quickly go with our new pickaxe and hack away one of the giant boulders that are blocking our path on the farm here. And then we'll go and head into the mines for the last bit of resources that we're going to need for selling, so that we can get a chicken coop. And I actually have a pretty good pickaxe isn't strong enough. Dang it! So we need the iron pickaxe, which is, I think, 5,000 gold in terms of how much money it's going to cost, which really, really sucks, but can't do much about it, so we're gonna head right into the mine and go down as far as we can go. We want to get to level 40 anyway, since that'll be another quest, and I think we'll get a sword reward for that. Another leak. Why is it now that as soon as we find the one leak that took us, like, I don't know, 3 weeks to find, we start finding everything? All the time, leaks everywhere. Don't make sense. So once we hit 40, I think we get a sword upgrade. Now we can hack those lighter colored rocks in too. That took a while. Die. Please just die. You take forever. Okay. So we're not gonna go down the shaft just yet, because it's only 5 levels that we need to go before we get to level 40, so we're just gonna make sure there's nothing sitting around here. It doesn't look like it, so we're just gonna go down. Ooh, copper. And now we can break it open in 2 hits instead of 3. And that'll be good, because we can sell that, too. Once we make sure that we have enough ore to upgrade the wooden axe. Because we're going to need that upgraded to iron, I believe, as well. Or it'll be a steel hatchet. Get rid of the buckles, and get rid of these guys. Because I'm pretty sure they also provide reward for destroying a certain amount of them. So like I've always said, it's better to just do it while we're here. Some quartz. And we can actually refine those into refined quartz bars. However, there's not too much that uses them in recipes right now, so it's not like it's a huge issue if we sell them. Because we can always come back here and just grab them. And then, like, there's a lot of the recipes don't use it for, like, more than 1 or 2 refined quartz at a time, so it's not a big deal. Stairwell. Lots of copper in here, holy. Get all the copper. Oh, there's a stairwell. Good, so we don't even need to waste energy looking for one. I know. Sneeze. Ugh. Excuse me. It wasn't nearly as bad as I was expecting, though. Alright. Nothing else to mine on this level, so down we go, and we're one level off afterwards. Now, is there anything else down here? There's some quartz. Aha! Take that. I'm not seeing anything else. There's a crate with a cave carrot. And those are used in root platter recipes, which is with a... I can't remember, it's like a winter root that you get in the winter when you're foraging. But they can be used for that, and they're also used in one of the bundles in the community center. And we reached level 40! Now we've got to reach the bottom. What do we get here? The slingshot. I personally find the use completely useless. The slingshot is just not worth it. It requires, obviously, ammo, which is fine. It's just, it doesn't have a big use. Slimes are a little different. I'm not going to be wasting time with them because there's... You just need so many of them. I think it's like 1,000 or something you needed to kill in order to get the reward. Which is just like a little ring that makes it so slimes lower level don't attack you. The dust sprites you definitely want to kill though, because there's usually... If they don't show up on a level, it's fine, but you do need quite a few of them as well, but they're also usually in a group. So it's better... Ooh, see, we find quartz from ice crystals. And we're also getting iron, which is awesome, because we can start working towards getting that iron pickaxe, which will then allow us to destroy those big boulders. And we've got 8 iron right now. And I'd like to have... Well, we need 25. So we kind of need to do that, and we need to get it anyway. I'm just getting rid of this thing, because I don't want to deal with this crap. Now we've got a bunch of bats coming for us. Get rid of that. And we're just going to hop down in the hole. I don't want to leave until we have enough for 5 iron bars. And the reason for that is because I don't want to have to come back down here later. And that way we can just start selling all the other iron that we have. After we refine it, of course, because it is better to refine it. I think, like, gold bars sell for 250, whereas the regular ore itself only sells for 25, something like that, or 20, something around the same price, but... Okay, you guys really need to just die, please. Especially you, Mr. Slime. Okay, do we have any crap we don't need? Well, we've got cookies, and I am gonna use that. Because that'll heal us, and give us some more energy. And dust sprites can actually jump off of rocks and break them. So they aren't always, you know, stuck where they are. They'll sometimes jump on the rocks to get at you. But they don't do a lot of damage, I don't believe. No, it's only like 4 damage. and that goes down. Once you get, like, the boots, closer to the bottom of the cave, or the mine, they only do, like, one hit of damage. And see, this is also why we want to get the iron pickaxe, so that we're able to break through those rocks in a hit, too. Oh, and look at that. Probably all the iron that we're gonna need for now. Iron, copper, and gold are also used in creating bombs, and of course, the higher the quality of the ore, meaning if it's copper, iron, or gold, it'll make a bigger bomb with a bigger explosion. So the copper will make the cherry bombs, the iron will make the normal bombs, and then the gold plus solar essence and void essence make the mega bomb, which basically blows up all the stones in like one room. Not on the whole level, mind you, because you do take damage from getting hit by them. So you don't want to stand there when the explosion goes off. Oh, we're almost at floor 50. I wasn't realizing that we were going that fast. We're also getting a crap ton of iron, which is also great. Once we hit 50, I think we get a better sword or boots. One or the other. Some more jade. Frozen geode. I know my inventory is full. And like I said, dust sprites, you wanna fight them, because you don't wanna... I had to do it on the other, on my main file, and you do not wanna have to go looking for them, because it sucks. Because sometimes they don't even spawn at all. Like, floor 45 to 55 is usually about the levels that they spawn. So, yeah, like I said, it sucks going looking for them. And we just got a coffee bean, which means that we can start planting coffee. Now, coffee doesn't sell for necessarily much. However, it does get varying levels of quality. And the way the coffee beans tend to work is you get about, I think it's like 4 or so beans from every plant, and they do regrow, kind of like corn and strawberries. But the first bean that comes off is the one that has the chance to be of normal, medium, or high quality. The other beans will just be normal, will be low quality. So it is within your best interest once you're able to. And what I tend to do is use all the low quality beans for planting and sell the other quality beans, because it's just more money that way. And like I said, since they regrow, it's not like you're going to be having an issue where you can't get more. I do want to try to get to floor 50, but I don't think we're going to reach it. Because I've already gone through this whole floor here. And I haven't been able to find a staircase, which really sucks. Oh, I don't want to lose this. Tundra boots. Okay, we gotta get out of here. After we put on the new boots. Takes us about a minute, minute and a half to get back to the house. If we're going the long way, which we're not, because that would really suck, because then we'd lose everything that we just found. Oh, we're cutting it close. We're gonna cut it really, really close, guys. I'm hoping that we... Okay, we're good. We're totally good. Okay, so we're going to take this moment here just to quickly reorganize, because we do have things that we want to sell. Frozen tears sell for a pretty decent amount. We're going to sell that amethyst. We're going to sell the leek because we don't need it now. Jade, we probably want to hold on to one of them. Actually, you know what I'm just thinking? Probably want to hold on to, we don't need those. One frozen tear and one piece of jade for the museum. And we don't want to sell that. Oh, that would have sucked. Let's just get that refining so that when we wake up tomorrow, we are able to grab it. Oh, and for some reason you can't go to sleep when you're holding things like that. Level 4 mining, which means we can transmute iron. And I believe that means that we need a lot more copper bars in order to turn them into iron, which I've never used because, like I said, once you're in the mine, it's just easier to just find them yourself. It might take a little bit of looking around, but it's not like it's gonna take forever to find something. Coffee beans. Okay, so we can plant that bean right now. And it grows in spring and summer. Ooh, that was close. I almost ended up hacking away my strawberries plant. Which would have sucked. Because they aren't ridiculously expensive or hard to come by, but it does suck when you end up hacking away a plant that's been growing for a bit. And we do have 4,000 gold. Which means that we can, quickly go to Robin, find out how much resources we're gonna need, and get that chicken coop built. Oh, let's water Kitty. I almost forgot to water Fluffy. Actually, I'm just gonna quickly check here on the wiki. Stardew chicken coop. Wood and 100 stone. Okay, well, we have 63 stone, and I think we actually have some sitting in the storage here too. Yes, we do. So we do have the stone that we need. What we need is the wood, and we have 63 sitting in there, so we need 239. I can math and math good. Wait, 239? What am I thinking? 237. Okay, I can't math so good. We're gonna go over here, because if I remember correctly, there's a good concentration of wood over here. Now, I would like to get that coop built, or at least started today, because it takes about 2-3 days for Robin to build something. And that tends to be across the entire board. For anything you ask her to build, it takes about 3 days, because she doesn't build it the day that you ask her to start. Which is kind of sucky, but what you gonna do? Hack our way through all of this. And I actually am tempted to put the chicken coop here, but I feel like it's just too out of the way. I was gonna start hacking away the stone, but then I figured that's gonna waste the energy that we so desperately need for this. Okay, so we're at 84, so we need, still quite a bit. I do have cave carrots, though. So I can eat those for energy, which I'm going to just do it right now. Cave carrots are also really easy to get. You can take your hoe down with you into the mines, and if you dig on any of the ground patches that they have down there, a lot of the time you'll find rock carrot. So it's not like it's a huge deal to go and get. And a lot of the time it ends up dropping off of monsters. And speaking of items dropping off monsters, the reason I'm saying that we need to kill those sprites is because one of the rewards for killing so many of them is an item that gives minions, their enemies, basically another roll for a chance to drop another item. So, like, say, a dust sprite drops coal. It gets a completely separate roll to drop another piece of coal, for instance. So it's not like it's increasing the chances that one roll is going to work. It's a completely separate roll from everything else. And that's called the Thieves' Ban or something like that. So it's definitely worth it to do. In fact, I think it's probably one of the better rings in the game. Especially later on once we get to something called the Skull Cavern, which is, you won't get any access to it until the bus stop's repaired, and until, you get to the bottom of the mines, because then you get the Skeleton Key, which, unlocks the door to get into that mine. And the difference between that and the mine that we have here is that, is that it doesn't have elevators. The Skull Cavern is just, you go in there and you try to get as far down as you go, and of course the deeper you go, the better stuff you find. It's one of the only places to find an iridium ore. The only place you can find iridium ore other than there is by the, it drops off of harder enemies down in the mines itself by chance. So iridium ore is very, not so much difficult to get, but it is a pain. Because that's the last thing that you can upgrade your items to, and that costs about 25,000, gold to get. But if I remember correctly, an iridium pickaxe also increases the chances of getting a geode off of things when you break them. Ah, we're so close! Okay, there's gotta be a maple tree I can shake down or something. Where's your seeds? Where's your seeds? I might have just cut down all the maple seeds, which really, really sucks. Although I might have stored some in the box, I also doubt it. Because I think if I remember correctly, that was the one that we were... Oh, no, we have a maple seed! Yes! Let's quickly hack down a random tree, and if we're lucky, it should give us the last bit of wood that we need to go with Robin. We should be able to get the chicken coop started today, or tomorrow, but you know what I mean. 231, so I need 6 more. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now, what time is Robin open till? 5, okay, so yeah, we can totally get there in time. Wood. Nope, stone. While we're at it. There. Okay, up we go! Awesome, we can get a chicken coop started. We're gonna put it somewhere over there. Away from the, plant area, because I don't have the energy to untill the land. and I won't be able to place down the chicken coop there, which is so silly. I feel like if you put the chicken coop on, or building on where tilled soil is, and there's no plants on it, it should just overwrite that tilled soil and turn it back to regular. Construct me a coop. Please, and thank you. Put it right here. Awesome, we got a chicken coop! Makes me quite happy. So let's just quickly go down here. And, yep, take the items that we have. Grab a daffodil for Alex. Although we can't do anything with it until Sunday, which is when the gifting thing resets. Because you can only do 2 gifts in a week. And it kind of makes sense, because if you know what they like and you're able to get it easily, then you can just shoot them up in friendship really, really fast. And that kind of defeats the purpose of the whole fun part. Oh, it's right, it's locked to 4, and I'll bet you this is locked. Oh, no, it's not. Sweet. Stone. Oh, sweet, so we got 2 rewards. What do we get? Starfruit seed and a standing geode. Pretty. Starfruit's really expensive, too. I probably won't do anything with the seed. Well, I could plant it in summer and then pluck it. But I won't sell it. And the reason I'm not going to do that is you can actually get a thing called a seed maker, so you're able to put a crop in it, and it generates 1 to 3 seeds. And if we're lucky, we'll get 2 or 3 so that we can make more and more seeds, and then we don't have to worry about buying them, because the starfruit seeds are actually pretty expensive, if I remember correctly. It's like, 200, I want to say? That doesn't sound right. But starting out, they're very expensive. Plop that in there, plop those in there. That in there, because I don't need it. Plop those, that. Awesome. And now we're gonna go to sleep. And we will just quickly look at what we get for today. I don't imagine too much. Level 3 foraging. Now we can get sap from trees. And yeah, that's it for today, guys. Thanks for watching. If you liked what you saw, please hit the like and subscribe button so you can stay up to date with all the videos that I post. And leave a comment in the comment section below so that you can tell me what games you want me to be playing next. Thanks for watching. Bye!